So, hello everyone. Today we want to start with the ammonia process. And yeah, so I think for the next three or four lectures, we will talk about the ammonia process. And today we will start very simply. And yeah, so what's the overview for today? So I found an example of an ammonia synthesis loop at the pressure level of 300 bars. So nowadays you don't have that high pressures anymore. It's more or less in the range of 200 bars, but it's an old example, but I think we can simulate it. This is taken from the Römp. It's an encyclopedia about chemistry, and you can find it when you're using the VPN. You have free access to the Römp. Yeah, today I want to show you the process layout, including the steps compression, the heat exchange. So there's a lot of heat exchange going on, the reactor for the production of ammonia, and the separation at the end of it. And this is the final goal or the final destination, what we want to achieve together in DW Sim. The start today is a simplified process with only compression, equilibrium reactor, and separation. So very simplified, but as a first step, I think this is okay. And yeah, the outlook is, so the next time we will talk in detail about the temperature behavior of the reactor and also including the reaction kinetics. So here, last year I was in Frankfurt, and at the Dechema, you can see one of the first ammonia reactors that were built. So it is from 1943. It was installed in Leuna, and this has a capacity of 3 tons of ammonia per hour. So if you look at ammonia production plants from nowadays, they have a capacity of up to 2,000 tons per day. So this should be 72 tons per day, and the modern plants have 2,000 tons per day. So there's a major improvement of this technique, but basically this is just like a plug flow reactor where you inlet it at the top and then you leave it at the bottom or vice versa. But this is how it looks like. And it's massive steel. You see, it's not very big, but it's like 50 tons of steel. Okay, so the process layout. I did a lot of PowerPoint animations today, so I want to show this to you. So we start here with the feed gas to the reactor, but we are not just feeding it directly to the reactor, but we have a preheating before entering it. So there's also a lot of heat exchange going on inside of the reactor, but this we will come in one of the next we will come to this in one of the next lectures. So here you have your feed gas with a high amount of hydrogen and nitrogen, and you send it to the reactor, high pressure, high temperature, and then your ammonia is produced. Then it's still very hot. Normally you have, like here, after internal heat exchange, you have a temperature of 300 degrees. You first send it to a steam generator. So here you put in water, liquid water, and then you produce steam. You can use it nearly everywhere inside an ammonia plant. So here your off gas from the reactor is cooled down. Then you send it to a second heat exchanger, and this is an internal heat exchanger. So the steam is sent to some place, to somewhere else inside the ammonia plant. But here, with the off gas from the reactor, so you cool it down and you preheat the gas going to your reactor. Okay. Then you send this to a condenser. So here you use just cooling water. You cool it down to 30 degrees Celsius, and here you can separate a big amount of ammonia already. So since we have a high pressure level here of nearly 300 bars, you have Yeah, you can separate a lot of ammonia already here. So since you are removing ammonia here, so at one place in the process you have to add some material. You cannot just only remove something, but you also have to insert something. And this is done at the top. Here you have your reformer gas. So basically, so normally you have a steam reformer. There you use steam and methane to produce hydrogen. And you also have nitrogen you need it for the ammonia production. And you have some small amounts of methane and argon. And then you have here the compression unit. So normally you compress it to a certain pressure level, and then you have cooling in between. This is good for the efficiency and for the temperatures. Otherwise, you need very expensive materials. We don't want to do this. So if you see this, then it always means there's a cooler in between. And these four compressors, they are powered by a steam turbine, and the steam is 510 degrees Celsius and 115 bars. So I found an example and I took it from there. Okay, so here you have the fresh gas, and here you have some yeah you here you have some gas where the big amount of ammonia is already removed. And then in the last compressor stage, you mix the two flows. So here you still have a high pressure level. So maybe due to the pressure losses here, maybe you have a pressure range of 280 bars or 260 or whatsoever. But at least you have to make sure that your pressure is high enough even for the recycle flow. Okay. And then the outlet from the last compression stage is sent first to an internal heat exchanger. So temperature is not very high, 35 degrees Celsius maybe. You have cooling afterwards here after your last stage, and then you have 35 degrees Celsius. And then you have a second ammonia removal. So here you have a rather low temperature, 3 degrees Celsius. You still have the high pressure. Now it's again 300 bars. And this means here again you can remove a lot of ammonia from your process. And how is this done? This low temperature. So you store your ammonia as a liquid under atmospheric pressure in big tanks. And to do this, you have to cool down your ammonia to, I don't know, should be something like minus 15 degrees or minus 20 degrees or whatsoever. This means you take some amount of your storage tank with a very low temperature. You use it here inside this condenser, and there the ammonia coming from the storage tank is evaporating, and the ammonia here inside our recycle gas is condensing, and then you can remove it, and both streams can then be put back to the storage tank. Okay. And why do you have this internal heat exchange here? So with this, you can make sure, so if you have like, I don't know, if you have an outlet temperature here of 3 degrees Celsius, then you can do the pre-cooling here. So you don't have to cool down your recycle gas here from 35 degrees Celsius to 3 degrees Celsius, but you have like a temperature level that is somewhere in between here. So this is good for the energy efficiency of your process. And then we are already done, or we are almost done. We just have to close our loop. So we have an outlet temperature here of 15 degrees Celsius. Now our loop is closed, and then we have the feed gas to the reactor with 15 degrees Celsius. We have the preheating, we send it to the reactor, and then the loop is closed. So is this all? So if I'm asking like this, then you can be sure that it's not the case. What are we doing here? So we are removing here Only ammonia. So here is ammonia, here is an ammonia flow, and here is also ammonia flow. But to the system, we are also sending, we are not only sending hydrogen and nitrogen, but we also have methane and argon. And if we put it here into the process all the time, but we are not removing it, then your system would consist after a while only of methane and argon, and your process would not run anymore. So that's why you have to make sure that a part of the methane and argon is constantly removed from the process, and this is done by purging. So purging just means you remove a certain amount of your flow all the time. Maybe then you can burn it or whatever. An ammonia plant, you will find something where you can burn it. So it's not a big thing, not a big thing. But without this, your process would not work, and you wouldn't be able to run a simulation, because in the simulation you would have the same problems, that your equations are not converging, because at the end you will end up with an infinite volume flow of methane and argon, because you are just putting it in but not removing it. Okay. That's the layout of an ammonia plant as it is given in the Römp. Okay. Some remarks. So the reformer gas consists mainly of hydrogen and nitrogen. Oh, I forgot to put it as an index. The ratio should be something in the range of 3 to 1. So 3 times 3 moles of hydrogen for every mole of nitrogen, and you have little amounts of methane and argon. You need a pressure increase from 30 bars to 300 bars by 4 compression stages. If you have a pressure level of only 200 bars, then maybe it's enough to have 2 or 3 compression stages. Ammonia is separated first by cooling water and then by liquid ammonia. And you use this liquid ammonia from storage tanks. You have an internal heat recovery to reduce the cooling load of the ammonia cycle. And yeah, basically that's the layout. But for today, we want to start with a simplified process as the introduction. So for the simplified process, we are just looking at the compression of our feed gas. And again, our 4-stage compression is run by a steam turbine. You mix before your 4th stage, you mix the recycle flow with the fresh feed. Then you have the high pressure. You send the high pressure to the reactor. We do it very simple with an equilibrium reactor. Then you have a phase separation here. Let's just assume it's 5 degrees Celsius, and then you send it back. And for the simulation to work, you need a purge here. Without the purge, you will not get proper results. Okay, in DW Sim, for the ammonia reactor, we use an equilibrium reactor. For the condenser, we use a gas-liquid separator, and herefore we use compressor and expander. Some more information: the reformer gas, the temperature should be 45 degrees Celsius, a pressure of 30 bars. As the property package, use NRTL for all components except water and steam. And the composition at the inlet should be like this. And one of your tasks for the homework is to determine the volume flow, or I will ask you for the mass flow. So I will not give you this, but you have to find it. You have to find it out by yourself. Okay, the turbine. Use high pressure steam with a temperature of 510 degrees Celsius and 115 bars. Here you use steam tables as the property package for water. You already know this for the hydro power plant. Make sure that for the first property package you choose NRTL, and second you choose steam tables. Otherwise, you have to modify it for every new material stream or process unit you open up. Then assume a turbine efficiency of 80%. You have to make sure that there will be no liquid at the turbine outlet. You can check this with the vapor content of your material stream. The turbine must provide the power for the compressors. Unfortunately, this cannot be done automatically by DWSim, but you just have to make sure that the power consumption of your four compressors is fulfilled by the turbine. And again, the mass flow or the volume flow, you should determine how much steam do you need for this process. The compressor efficiency of 75%, you do a cooling in between. You cool the volume flow down to 30 degrees Celsius by a simple cooler in front of the compressor 4. You mix the reformer gas with the recycle stream, and this can be done by a mixer. I think it's also default, but make sure that your pressure calculation, you choose inlet maximum. And yeah, here you should find a reasonable choice for the pressure rise in every compressor stage. For the reactor, choose equilibrium reactor. There's something very similar. It's called the Gibbs reactor, but here we want to have the equilibrium reactor. You have to define the equilibrium reaction under settings, and you have to define the outlet temperature of the reactor to 450 degrees Celsius. Then after your reaction, you have to separate the ammonia from the recycle flow. There you set the temperature to 5 degrees Celsius and the pressure to 280 bars. And this can be done with the override check boxes. The temperature, this means that you cool it down. I already told you, you do it first by steam production, then by internal heat exchange, and then by cooling water, and then by liquid ammonia, and so on. And this we want to do in a very simplified manner. We just say, okay, separation temperature is 5 degrees Celsius, and the pressure here is 280 bars. This means that we would have like 20 bars pressure loss inside our reactor and in the heat exchangers. And what we want to have at the end, you should have a simulation with a mass flow of liquid ammonia of 800 tons per day. So if you look here, there it's 800 tons per day. This is what you should have at the outlet from the gas liquid separator. For the purge stream, there you have to make sure that your mole fraction of methane plus the mole fraction of argon, this should be less than 14%. So I wrote here less, but it should be something like 14%. And for this, you just insert a splitter, and then you define the split rate. You play around with the split rate and make sure that this condition here is fulfilled. After that, you have to insert a recycle block to make sure that DWSim can find the solution, and this is necessary. If you don't do this, the process won't work. I recorded the videos on the DWSim simulation already. So I recorded the simulation and then this lecture here. So there will be a different information compared to the video. You should change the mass flow tolerance to 1 kilogram per hour, and also start with a mass flow of the recycle stream of 1 kilogram per hour. At the end of this video, I will do an update to the other videos. Hope this is not too confusing. Okay, so and here comes your homework. So every one of you should do the simulation. You should discuss your solution in your group. So yesterday I gave you the information on your groups. You found your name in some groups, so you have to contact the other people and compare your solutions. And then, so every group should prepare a document with your results and short remarks how to obtain how you obtained them. So this means at the end I only want to read 4 documents and not 24 PDF files. And so one document per group. And yeah, the questions you should answer is: what is the mass flow of the reformer gas? What are the pressure levels in the compression system? Justify your choice. What is the mass flow of steam to the turbine? What is the outlet pressure? Calculate the power of the compressors and turbine. What is the composition at the outlet of the reactor? What is the purge mass flow? Please don't just give me a PDF with only some figures, but for every question, maybe write a small comment how you obtained them, what you find difficult, easy, whatsoever. Make it a little bit like a small report. Okay. As I already told you on the last slide, I want to do an update to the other tutorial videos. Okay, let's go to DWSim. What I want you to do is go to the recycle block and set the mass flow tolerance to 1 here. So I already have it here, 1. And then you have to go to this recycle block and you should start here first with a mass flow of only 1 kilogram per hour. And at least for me, then the simulation worked fine and I got reasonable results after after a reasonable time. Okay, now it will take a while, but yes. Okay, so basically that's your homework. There will be 2 more videos on how to use DWSim with all these new components, with the mixer, splitter, reactor and so on, so you don't have to find it out by yourself, but I will guide you through this, but I will not give you the results. This you have to do on your own. Okay, good luck for the simulation and stay healthy. Goodbye.